Alright, time for some more of The Legend of Zelda, Link to the Past. Ah, good. We already start out in the Dark World. So, where in the world is 3? It's in the Lost Woods, eh? Well, while I'm here, I'm going to be doing a fair bit of exploring. In fact, I wonder what in the world is at the witch's house over there. Kind of interesting that you would figure, being in the Dark World, that the fairies would look a little different than they do in the real world. But, well, I guess they're magical. Perhaps they all have a moon pearl within themselves, so to speak. No! Did I take away 2 health? Yeah. So much for the whole full health thing, but now I'm really looking forward to when I get the blue tunic. At least I think it's the blue tunic. It gives me half of the hit power. So for example, instead of them taking 4 hearts away, it'll only take 2 hearts away. It's another shop. I don't really need anything. In fact, I kind of wonder why I would need to buy the other sword. I don't think there are any life locks in this game, are there? Curse, is there anybody who throws something into my circle of stones? Wondering where this part came from.
Is it you who disturbed my peaceful nap? I will give you this if you go away.
There it is. This is the Quake Medallion. Its magic causes the ground to shake and defeats nearby enemies. Watch your magic meter. Excellent. Oh, giddy. Use one of those. I'm trying to think, are there any other odd housing areas around this area? I wonder what in the world that is. Oh no, not the bees! Not the bees! Ah! They think they had bees in this world. I guess it would make sense. Take a quick stop off at that fairy fountain real quick. So I'm right on death's door. And now I'm alive again. Is that really just the dungeon up there? It looked like it might have been something else. This seems important. Another portal, of course. Is there anything in this one? Fairies. Just tripping all over them, aren't I? You can't catch me, I'm going to another world. Hmm. guess I'm taking the roundabout way, but I am getting there. I wonder about those two houses, perhaps. Hmm. Ooh, we got a shooting gallery? Well, howdy, Lad Walder. You look like a straight shooter. Wanna try your skill in our shooting gallery? I give you 5 shots for 20 rupees. If you're as sharp as I think you are, you stand to take a rake in rupees. How about it, stranger? Alright, aim carefully. Ready? Go. I'd like to try that again, please. No! Yeah. I think that's it. Oh well. Guess I'm a little eager on that one. Hmm. Oh, that one's too heavy. Is there any other way around? Doesn't look like it. Gonna keep going anyway. What does this odd creature have to say? Welcome to the treasure field. The object is to dig as many holes as you can in 30 seconds. Any treasure you dig up will be yours to keep. It'll only be 80 rupees. Yeah, why not? Press the Y button to dig. I said to dig as many holes as I can. No! So close. Time's up. Game over. Come back. Again. Yeah, I can't just use the shovel on its own. I wonder if there's some sort of heart piece in there, perhaps. Or, is there still a tree there in the light world? There is. Guess I gotta be a little further in. Right. It's the enchanted grotto again, right? Hmm. When the world did I get there before? Or did I? Found exactly what I was looking for. Now, basically, you'll see that there is an other entrance all the way to the left there. Well, you want to go that way, slightly to the right, and then back down to this other entrance. You lift a rock, smash these two things in with the hammer, and you're in another hole. Oh dear, that's what this version of the chickens look like, the cuckoos. I couldn't think of the name for some reason. Yeah. Now that we are just outside the Bizarro Kakariko Village, I'm very curious as to what there is here. Well, nothing there. Let's see what this says. This is the village of outcasts. People without rupees are not welcome here. Well, I've got rupees. Is this another one of those? Hi, may I help you? You can open two chests for 30 rupees. Why don't you play? No thanks. Well, come back and play sometime. I'll be waiting for you. Until then, goodbye. I'm a thief. This house was completely destroyed. Well, I remember how to do this one. No, wait. No, I gotta pull on it. Of course, that's going one too far ahead, I think. Another bee! Ah! Okay, I figured it would say something a little different, perhaps, but... I remember in the real world... Yes, there we are. Dang it, I don't need 300 rupees. Anyway, so I'll show it for the people trying to make a walk through this at home. If anybody is trying to make a walk through this. To that house up there. What about those two? How do I get into this place? Must be one of those portals around here. Right. Okay, I was wrong. Figured it was worth a shot at least. Around. Let's actually get to the third dungeon of this world. If you give a piece of heart to the person who wears the cape. No! I wanted to see what was in the cave! Right. Forgot about that. Heh. guess. Lucky guess. I can't very well get through there, can I? Something happens when I drop. Absolutely nothing. I'd have to somehow get into this place from the other side, wouldn't I? Alright, what is this house in this dimension? Another shop. Through this way, I'm sure. Not the bee! Okay, can ignore the shrubbery there. Yeesh, you can get trained real easily in this world. I could just barely make out the image of one of those weird blob things. Is that what killed me? Don't hit the blob thing. What's the other entrance? So that's what grabs him. And another bee! No! Try to figure this place out a little bit before I perish again. Stupid. I hate it. Why must it be doing this to me? I have no idea what that was supposed to be. Cheese it, I guess. Okay. Oh! Oh, wait. It starts me back, doesn't it? Bring me back! Yeah! Especially not. Can't really cross that way. There's no other keys. Something. I those things were in this game. You know. Excellent. Okay, this one. Maybe going backwards. Get to the chest. Woo! Yes! Not sure if that's gonna help me a whole lot, but I'm a bunny again. I wonder what's over here. Let's see, which one is the fire? Bumbles? Ether? Gonna go with Bumbles. I do know I need fire to get into this place. So I can cheese it, but I guess I gotta find the fire wand first. And I did find the maps, so that's something. Hopefully it's a real one this time. Good. Not so good. That's different. Two areas together, but that appears to be all, unless I don't have a key. Now I have a key. Even though I'm dead. In this room? Doesn't look like it. Yeah, guess I just have to have the hand grab me. doing a fair bit of jumping around here. Not only to make it a more pleasant viewing experience, but also to make it a more pleasant editing experience. So, discovered another room here. If you fall down a pit, you can land in the room to the left. And I found this chest. Let's see what's in it. A compass. I wonder why in the world there's so many holes now. It wasn't like that before. Huh? Let's see, have I gone up? Let's go up. Dang, I can shoot through the walls. Dang it. I seem to be... No! Oh, I just go back to the room I started with. So now you can see how I roughly got to where I was. Thankfully the Master Swords does pretty quick work of these guys. Which is nice, because wow, they're very annoying. Nope! And there goes my perfect heart thing. Nope! This is going to be quite challenging. I didn't think I went that far. Alright. I also want to mention I got some fairies before I came back here to make things just a wee bit easier. You know what? I'm gonna take care of you first, because wow. At least the Gyptos just take a lot of health. I mean, a lot of hit points. I am very sorry, I just can't seem to make words. Maybe after enough time it'll all start making sense. Well, at least I know. I was hoping one of them would drop a heart, but I guess not. Right. The treasure chest. I'm assuming I probably have to drop down offhand. Hey, I got a heart. This is very interesting. I'm just like, why have I not gone up? But that's because of the big hole. Unless... Ooh! I don't know why it caught that time, but hey, it worked. Time to get all the stuff. No! Now the thing's not gonna know where to go. It's anywhere else out of this room? No, just through the wall. I moved out of the way enough. Right. Open the switch. Or maybe I should have just went for the classic. Pull the lever, Kronk. Let's see, is this how I get to the treasure? Yes. Give me a fire rod! I'm not gonna lie, I was hoping for the blue tunic. But you know what? The fire rod is also important too. This rod commands the red fire. Don't watch your magic meter. That's where they say watch your magic meter on everything. And now, beeping begins. Yeah, that was close. Don't have any more keys, so I can't go down. So I'm gonna go out. And now I've got fire and ice. Which also made a very good Pat Benatar song. Now, hope they're able to get to the area that actually uses the fire rod. Nope! Get off! Thank you. I don't think I want to go down there. Yeah. One more hit and I'm as good as toast. Yes! Aha! Time for a little bit of magic. I can honestly say I have no idea how I figured that out the first time. Unless maybe there was a clue somewhere. And now, we are at the real start of the castle. Well, dungeon, castle, I call them the same thing sometimes. Fascinating. Well, maybe those die in one hit at least. No! Wait a second. Is in the way. So let's see, there's just one door up there. There's no way for me to get down. Huh. That's real nice. After doing some meandering, and unfortunately losing both of my fairies, I did manage to get into this one room. Hopefully, there is a key in here. More importantly, I hope I won't die instantly. Okay. Oh, there we go. That's nice. Okay. There's a key. Yeah, is there anything else in this room? I'm not wasting the key there, so I'm going to cut back when I get back to the insect part. I'm certainly happy I'm doing a lot of these jump cuts because, wow, I would have to do a lot of editing out. Let's just say I've been getting lost and dying a lot. Now, at least I got the key, so that's good. I feel like I was going for the longest. Well, excuse me, princess. You really don't have time to think, do you? Before you think, you must feel. Ouch. Dang it, I could use that heart. Give me the magic! Keeps playing the jingle. Okay, it looks like that is the only way forward. So I'm going to take it. Would you kindly die already? There we go. I got the fairies, so I'm not too concerned. But I am very annoyed. Yeah, if only I had more magic power. So I appear to be fighting Mothman. Well, I can tell I'm gonna need a lot of magic before I can do this one proper. Unless I can just shoot it with arrows. Try that again, but I want to be better equipped for the challenge that I have to face. Well, not the stats I was hoping for, but hopefully this will be good enough. Let's try it out. I don't think I've beaten this guy. Okay, I guess I did beat him. Well, there we go. Yeah. That was probably the most annoying dungeon by far. Let's finish this. Agumon, because of you I can escape from the clutches of the evil monsters. Thank you. Do you think the prophecy of the Great Cataclysm? Oh, do you know the prophecy of the Great Cataclysm? This is the way I heard it. If a person who has an evil heart gets the Triforce, a hero is destined to appear, and he alone must face the person who began the Great Cataclysm. If the evil one destroys the hero, nothing can save the world from his wicked reign. Only a person of the Knights of Hyrule, who protect the royalty of Hylia, can become the hero. You are of their bloodline, aren't you? Then you must rescue Zelda without fail. Do you understand? Yes. May the way of the hero lead you to the Triforce.
Wow.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna call it an episode there. Thank you for joining me on this long and quite annoying dungeon. Until next time, keep having fun.